And this, of course, is Kathy Brock's last day.
There's a force that she brings with her to her work that I think is her personal and professional focus that is carried along with it. At the same time, what many people may not see is how, quite frankly, how interested she is in other people's lives. And I'm talking about the people that we work with, how compassionate she is when somebody's going through difficulty.
Her intelligence, her wit, her smooth, silky, soothing voice.
I remember from day one when I walked into the station 17 years ago, I have always been impressed by her presence on the anchor desk, her commanding presence. That to me is truly second to none. Tonight, Kathy Brock will anchor her last 10 o'clock newscast here on ABC 7. And we are saying thanks, Kathy, as she signs off for the last time.
That's right. What a week it really has been. And our viewers are learning some things that they never knew about this veteran TV anchor. And on Windy City Live, Kathy talked about her love of home decorating.
We've learned about you as of late is that you love to decorate. Like, you really have a knack for it.
I promise the real decorators are not in any danger.
No, I hear that they are, actually. I hear that they are.
I like to throw stuff away, minimalism, paring through all this stuff, I really do. And I've done it, you know, for the places that we've had over the years. I like to do it for my kids.
And Kathy says that while growing up, her mother used to make very nice things for their home out of minimal materials.
It's been a fun week. Yeah,
it really
looking
has.
Back at her phenomenal career.
Yeah, a lot of testimonials. It's going to be an emotional night around here, and hope that you'll join us a little bit
tonight later. Tonight at 10 o'clock. Well, we are saying thanks, Kathy, all this week as she signs off ABC 7 tonight for the last time.
That's right. And we asked some of her coworkers to give us a one-word description of Kathy, and this is what we all came up with.
Having everyone come up with a word you think describes Kathy. A word that you think describes Kathy. One word. A Kathy word.
Just one?
Write it down. Okay.
In any color?
Whatever color.
Let's go with blue.
Write it and then hold it up to the camera, but not in front of your face.
Like this. With something like that.
You make sure to tilt it slightly downward.
One word, huh? Just one word.
One word.
That's a tough question.
What if I did three?
I'll use my best penmanship, too.
Well, Kathy, you're a Cinderella story, a farm girl out of Washington State, out of nowhere, about to win the Masters.
Now, I'm going with a kind of a serious word. Are people doing that?
Nah. She's got an automatic pencil sharpener under the desk.
If you've ever heard something like during one of our newscasts.
Okay, now people hopefully can read my writing.
Okay, Eric, this didn't work out very well.
And I spelled it right, too, right?
I hope I spelled that right.
You can read it?
Yes.
So after 28 years, Kathy's last newscast is tonight at 10 o'clock. We hope all of you will be joining us and watching that as Kathy signs off. Then starting tomorrow, I will be sliding into the 6 o'clock anchor chair, just shifting the schedule a little bit. You'll still see me here at 4, but along at 6 o'clock. But tonight is Kathy's last newscast.
Yeah, I have to tell you folks that there's a real feeling in the newsroom, which is upstairs from the studio here. Everyone is kind of a party feeling, but there's a tinge of sadness, and we hope to capture all of that a little bit later, and I know Kathy's going to be full value for the moment.
And her family is joining her tonight, you got to tune in.
All right, that's going to be great stuff, and so we will continue on right here, and we're going to talk a little bit about weather right now, and apparently it's going to get very hot. And it's summertime. Look, see, it's all red, right, Larry?
And for Friday and Saturday, those are going to be the hottest days. You know what I learned from that little piece we just did is that I have the worst handwriting of anybody right here. Did you see how bad that was? That was awful. It was like doctor handwriting, right?
It's time to bid farewell today to our friend and colleague, Kathy Brock.
This is our colleague Kathy Brock's final day of anchoring here at ABC 7. And there was a station-wide luncheon in her honor this afternoon. She was surrounded by family, friends, colleagues who have spent the last 28 years working with Kathy. We've been saying thank you all week long to Kathy with very special videos and other tributes. And we are not done yet, so be sure to join us for Kathy's final broadcast. That will be tonight at 6 o'clock and then later on tonight at 10 o'clock.
Yeah, be here for that.
Yeah.
I'm Kathy Brock. Tonight at 6, breaking news, the verdict in a court decision in a controversial police shooting and summer sizzle, climbing temperatures, turning up the heat. Coming up next on Eyewitness News, tonight at 6.
Live from Chicago's number one news, ABC 7 Eyewitness News at 6 starts right now.
We begin tonight with breaking news in the loop, where a jury has just found in favor of the family of Quintonio LeGuerre, who was shot and killed along with his neighbor Betty Jones by Chicago police officer Robert Rialmo.
Let's get right to ABC 7's Leah Hope. She was in court, now joining us live. Leah. Kathy reporting on the big stories. Look back at her illustrious reporting career right here on ABC 7.
Showers and storms on Sunday, then it stays hot for Monday, Tuesday, and for the 4th of July. And Kathy, I have to say, I know it's only been a few months that I've been able to sit next to you, but it's been an absolute privilege, and I'm going to miss you. And Alan, I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah, okay, Larry, yeah, I'll see you tomorrow. Yeah, we'll get back to this. Right.
Thanks, Larry.
All right, thank you, Larry. In just a few minutes, though, we're going to have a look back at Kathy's reporting career. And then tonight at 10, a look at her personal side. We'll let you in on a few things that you may not know about her.
What?
Be very concerned.
Mm-hmm.
And that's sports.
The report is controversial, but often cited by those who say unnecessary.
Yes, for decades, Kathy's covered Chicago stories and the news that's really impacted all of us. And she's covered issues from presidents to the Pope, floods, fires, all of this while raising her two sons. Yeah, it's a resume that is full of experience and truly the realization of a young journalist's dream. It was at a young age that Kathy announced she wanted to be like Barbara Walters. Well, then she went out and made her own distinguished career.
I never got her job, but I did get to interview her. And it was probably one of the scariest interviews of my life. Because who wants to interview the interviewer?
It's actually difficult to imagine Kathy being intimidated by anyone or anything. At heart, she's a reporter, and when she thinks of her career, the memories come flooding back.
We were able at that point to look in the tunnel and see the water rushing in.
In 1992, Kathy was one of the first reporters on the scene there for the Great Chicago Flood, as it was called, that shut down parts of the city for days. And then there was that horrible fire that roared through the Cook County Administration Building in 2003, killing 6 people.
And I said, why couldn't you get out? And they said, well, the doors were locked. And that's when we realized, through that interview, that there could be people who didn't get out.
There were the national event stories touching lives across the country.
Some members of the group determined to see the Pope in person.
Kathy was there in 1995 when Pope John Paul II said Mass in New York Central Park. Kathy's reporting chops, though, most evident in her in-depth special segments, including exposing potentially deadly blind cords.
I always felt really proud of that outcome because there is no question that that saved some child's life.
There are still delegates on the floor tonight. But
her political coverage also a mainstay. Over the years, she has covered national political conventions, focusing on the Illinois delegations.
A family gets into politics and you become a part of the process.
And then there was that one political interview in Hyde Park back in 2004 that proved to be especially significant.
Michelle and Sasha and Malia were there. And then he came home. And we did an interview with all of them. And the next day, I remember I was out shopping and I was talking to a guy that I knew and I said, I think that I met the first African-American president.
Last year brought a new chance to cover history with the inauguration of President Donald Trump.
This is what democracy looks like.
And the massive women's march the following day. Amazing events all the way through, Kathy, but it's difficult to condense 28 years of amazing work into whatever that was, a minute or so, but it's remarkable.
It's so much fun. I mean, it's been so great this week to look back. So this is not my final sign-off tonight. That comes tonight at 10. But this is my final 6 p.m. broadcast, and by my count, which isn't all that good, we've shared nearly 7,000, you and I, dinners together. And I so appreciate the trust and the faith that you put in us and that you have put in me. This guy sitting next to me, he is the best, and know that Alan, Judy, Mark, and Larry will be a really great team. And from now on, I'm going to be doing the same thing that you are, watching them from home. So thank you, and I hope I see you a last time tonight at 10.
We'll have a great time at 10, too. Yeah.
The party's still on, right?
That's right. Okay. That's right.
Everybody's
invited. Join us tonight at 10.